Samsung is no stranger to pushing the capabilities of its phones with a fingerprint sensor, camera, and now the sensor extension. Hi everyone, it's Michael, and in today's episode, we'll be showing you the Sensor Extension SDK. Let's get started with the overview. Samsung's latest Galaxy flagships all include the dedicated heart rate monitor at the back. While these sensors used to be exclusive to S Health, the Sensor Extension SDK now lets developers create apps that can measure heart rate and even ultraviolet or UV index. Now let's have a look at the architecture that makes it work. The sensor extension architecture shows two important parts. There's the Sensor Extension SDK API, which exposes the classes needed to make objects that you'll manipulate, and also the physical Samsung sensor, which records the data you can process in your app. Before we set up the SDK, let's first have a look at the requirements. To use the Sensor Extension SDK, you'll need a device with at least Android 4.4 KitKat or higher. Also, make sure that your device has the ultraviolet or heart rate sensors. The Galaxy S5 is no longer supported by the Sensor Extension SDK, but the Galaxy Note 4 and Galaxy Note Edge both have the ultraviolet and heart rate sensors, while the Galaxy S6 only has the heart rate sensor. Once you have a device that meets the requirement, it's time to get the SDK. You'll need to register with a Samsung account so you can fill up a form and apply for an SDK request. It may take a week to get your approval for the SDK. Once you get the SDK, you can get to developing your app. To start off, make sure to import the sensor extension and SDK jar files to your libs folder in Eclipse. Then for permissions, add access find location for the ultraviolet index and SSENSORMANAGER for the health rate monitor. To be able to initialize the SSENSOR extension, add the right use AP feature survey permission. Once you've imported the needed libraries and added the needed permissions, it's time to see how some of the classes are used. Let's take a look at the classes in the Sensor Extension SDK and how they are used. First off is the SSensor class. This class basically defines the attributes for each sensor which you can get, like name, vendor, version, type, and other values. Next is the SSensor Event class, which is mainly a placeholder for the values which the sensor will collect, such as the values, sensor type, accuracy, and timestamp. We'll show how this is used later. Next, we have the SSensor Extension class, primarily used for initializing the SDK and checking features. Once you instantiate a new object of SSensor Extension, you must call the initialize method with the context as parameter. If a device is not supported, the SSDK unsupported exception is thrown. In our example, we have MSSensorExtension as our SSensorExtension object. After you've initialized the SSensorExtension and didn't get exceptions, you should check for the supported features. To do this, you have to call the isFeatureEnabled function. It accepts an integer type which is defined in the SSensorExtension class. In the example, you can see hasUVFeature of type boolean, and it gets the return value of isFeatureEnabled. It checks for the ultraviolet sensor feature and shows by toast message if it's not supported. The next class we have is the SSENSORMANAGER, which can get the SSENSOR, register and unregister event listeners, and receive events. When you instantiate an SSENSORMANAGER object, you need to pass the context and the SSENSORExtension object you made earlier. In our example, the MSSensorManager is instantiated with the context and our MSSensorExtention object in a try-catch block, which can catch an illegal argument exception. With our SSensorManager and SSensorExtention objects initialized, we can now get an instance of the SSensor object. In our example, we want to get an instance of the ultraviolet sensor. So we define an SSensor object called MSSensorUV and initially set it to null, and then call MSSensorManager's getDefaultSensor method with the SSensor's type ultraviolet integer type as parameter. Once you get the value, you should check if the SSensor object is still null. So at this point, we already have three objects, the MSSensorExtension, the MSSensorManager, and MSSensorObjects. The next class we need to deal with is a listener for events. The Sensor Extension SDK has two types of event listeners, STRIGGEREVENTLISTENER and SSENSOREXTENSION. The S-Trigger Event Listener handles events that only happen once, which is for the ultraviolet sensor. The S-Sensor Event Listener handles events that happen continuously, which is for the heart rate monitor's infrared sensor and red sensor. In our example, we will deal with the S-Trigger Event Listener. To handle it, we first need to create a listener class which will extend S-Trigger Event Listener called Event Listener. Next, we'll need to implement the abstract methods. In our case, we only need to implement the onTrigger method, which accepts an S-Sensor event as parameter. In our example, we declared an S-Sensor object S, which gets the sensor object from the S-Sensor event parameter. We instantiate an object of string buffer SB to collect information from the sensor, which is displayed in the log. After getting the sensor details, we instantiate the string buffer object again this time to specifically get the values and timestamp from the S-Sensor event object. The values are then displayed in the log with the help of a for loop to go through the array of values. We then declare mListener, an object of type EventListener. Now that we have a listener for events, we need the SSENSORMANAGER to register and unregister the event listeners. In our example, we call the MSSensorManager's requestTriggerSensor in our activity's onResume method, passing our mListener object of type EventListener and MSSensorUV of type SSensor to register the listener. Similarly, we call the MSSensorManager's cancelTriggerSensor in our activity's onPause method, passing the same mListener and MSSensorUV objects to unregister the event listeners. There you have it, our simple code for getting the amount of ultraviolet light on the sensor of the phone. Now let's have a summary of our episode today. To wrap up today's episode, the Sensor Extension SDK lets developers make great apps that use the ultraviolet sensor and heart rate monitor, perfect for building health apps. Make sure that the device is running at least Android 4.4 KitKat, API level 19 or higher, and must have the heart rate monitor at the back. Remember to register at developer.samsung.com and wait for an approval email before you can get your hands on the SDK. To get started on coding, remember to start with the S-Sensor extension, which will be needed by the S-Sensor manager. The S-Sensor manager can then get an instance of the S-Sensor object, register and unregister event listeners at the onResume and onPause methods of the activity, respectively. There are two types of event listeners, namely, the S-Trigger event listener for ultraviolet and S-Sensor event listener for the heart rate. That concludes our episode for today on the Sensor Extension SDK. I hope it gave you ideas for making great apps that use the ultraviolet and heart rate monitor sensors. To get more details and technical information, please visit us at developer.samsung.com. Don't forget to give a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to Samsung Developers. Thank you for watching and see you soon on the next episode.